Get ready for the world premiere of Elias's brand new song.
Hello, I am Elias, and I am the man who...
Where did he come from?
I don't know, but thank you.
These two had an issue on social media about this song. That must be what this is all about.
You want to write stupid songs about me, huh? This is what happens. No one's ever going to hear it now. I'm shutting you up for good. You're never going to sing again.
It's one thing to take issue with a song lyric, but that crossed the line.
I agree, Michael.
Maybe you're right, but hey, at least we didn't have to hear Elias sing.
Yeah, we might not again for quite some time.
The voice of SmackDown may have been temporarily silenced, but Elias won't go down quietly as he takes on the superstar responsible for the ruthless attack.
Whoa, the voice of SmackDown? I thought that was you, Michael.
Very observant, Byron.
Wait, is anybody actually upset that Elias can't sing right now? Elias's opponent should be considered a hero.
Tough position to be caught in here.
Can't prepare your face for that.
He's got him scouted. Placed in the corner. Kick. Oh.
On the second roll.
Kanzigiri
out of the corner.
Oh, and a stomp.
Reverses it.
And responds with a counter of their own. He's getting a little battered now. Into the roundhouse kick.
Both wrists captured.
That was nasty.
No, he lets him out. Curious decision there, Michael.
For that one. Got him set up in the corner of the ring. And able to counter. Does he get him here? Look at this.
Curious decision there, Michael. A little thunder roll.
Here's the cover for the win. Sweat put into this match, well worth it.
Here is your winner, Mr. Amazing, the Falcon Black.
No other way to put it, guys. That was kind of a butt kicking.
With a win like this, things have got to taste a little bittersweet right about now.
Actually, Saxton, I imagine the win tastes a lot more like pennies.
Ever since Elias was first attacked on SmackDown, the war of words with his assailant has only intensified, all leading to tonight's no disqualification climax.
I believe the musical term is a crescendo, Cole, and the volume will be turned up all the way as both superstars look to have the last word.
If you ask me, Elias's opponent will be the one singing the blues after this encounter.
He got whipped into that corner. Oh, what a kick! vicious. And he follows it up with a big one in the face. Stop me in your tracks. He turns it around. An agile escape. Now he's been put on the defensive.
Yeah, he's not breathing heavy yet.
Quick reversal by Elias.
A counter answered by another counter. Side of things right now.
Yeah, Elias has to find an opening and respond.
Rolling thunder, face first.
He wants it one more time.
Standing shooting star. That's incredible.
And Elias is on.
And this one is over.
Here is your winner, Mr. Amazing, the Falcon.
Seemed like a pretty easy day at the office right there.
This is what you get when you have complete confidence and control of the situation.
Gentlemen, you are looking at a man who is sick of the doubters, sick of being questioned about his potential. And I can't disagree with him.
I expect tonight to be a night where he can silence the skeptics and prove to be the future of this company.
It will be a tall order, but the confidence he possesses could take him very far.
But then you have a competitor who needs no introduction. The Miz, the A-lister, a world-famous celebrity.
And I'm sure Miz is desperate to convince everyone here tonight that he is the biggest star in all of WWE.
Miz with a fireman's carry attempt. It's reversed.
Miz is in trouble here.
Wait, is that John Morrison? I thought he was out filming a movie.
Well, maybe they wrapped early. Morrison probably nailed all of his lines on the first take.
Miz with a roll-up.
And The Miz gets the win with the help of Morrison's distraction.
Hey, that's on his opponent for not staying focused on the match.
You have to wonder if this is all a setup on the part of Miz and Morrison.
I'm guessing that's a yes.
Look who it is, Johnny Hollywood himself. You know, I would say this whole thing was a setup from the beginning and there never was any movie, but based on your social media posts, I know you're not that smart.
I had the director adjust my filming schedule so I could wrap early and make it back in time for SmackDown. I just had to see Miz beat you in person.
I'm sure the director was more than happy to get a no-talent hack like you off his set. And the only reason I lost to your little stand-in was because you interfered.
Please. Miz had everything in complete control. He needs my help like he needs an acting coach, which is not at all, because he's amazing. We both are.
Okay, look. Since you're back from your big movie role, or more likely it was shut down for being so bad, let's figure this out in the ring. You good with that? Or do you need Miz to step in and fight your battles again?
I'm good with that. Real good. See? Now that's how you deliver a line. Take notes and be jealous.
Gentlemen, you are looking at a man who is sick of the doubters, sick of being questioned about his potential.
And I can't disagree with him. I expect tonight to be a night where he can silence the skeptics and prove to be the future of this company.
It will be a tall order, but the confidence he possesses could take him very far.
And John Morrison, he hasn't missed a single step since returning to WWE. As confident as he's ever been, thanks in large part to his best friendship with The Miz. Not that he can't get the job done by himself, of course.
And strikes!
Rights and lefts, elbows, knees, all of them lethal.
Morrison getting worked on right now.
Yeah, Morrison has to.
Perched up top. And Morrison was behind a step there.
He had to be prepared to take some damage tonight.
Absolutely brutal.
Ruthless.
Reversal! What a counter! He is hell-bent on putting his opponent away.
This has been a grueling battle. What is left?
Wait, you don't think he's...
Spanish Fly!
Locked in on the shoulder. He finds a counter for Morrison. Oh, strong impact! Ah, he turns it around. He fends off the attack. Precision strike to the back of the neck. This match's brutality starting to show on him.
Well, all things considered, Cole, it's not a bad condition to be in at this point in the match.
Will it be?
One, two.
Yeah, no, he doesn't get the three.
I cannot believe what I'm seeing right now.
No one can.
Oh, snapmare. Basement kick to the side of the face.
That may have grounded Morrison.
No contest.
An absolute statement by the victor here tonight. What a steamrolling.
What can I say? You got me out there tonight, but this is classic Hollywood storytelling. The hero always has to reach his lowest point before he can overcome the antagonist and prevail in the end.
Someone's read the back of a screenwriting book. Look, I beat you in the middle of the ring. Your story's over, and I don't think you were ever the hero.
Fine, so we had our match, but that's never what this was really all about. It was about movies and acting, so let's settle this the right way. Not confined to a ring, but in a fight with action and stunts and weapons.
So, a backstage brawl?
Yeah, basically, but it sounded a lot cooler the way I said it. You gotta sell these things. You should know that.
Okay, let's do this backstage movie fight stunt brawl thing. But spoiler alert, I'm the hero who's gonna prevail at the end. Oh, and make sure you have an on-set medic standing by. This could get ugly.
Watching this no DQ match, I can't help but think of all the great no disqualification matches we've seen in WWE over the years.
No doubt, Michael. Triple H versus Brock Lesnar in 2013. The Rock versus Mankind in 1999. Both classics. But the all-time best has got to be Undertaker versus Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania 26.
Yeah, I hate to disagree with you, Corey, but Stone Cold Steve Austin against The Rock at WrestleMania 17 was the greatest no disqualification match of all time. In fact, it might even be the greatest match in WWE history.
Let's just agree that all of those matches are great, and I'd argue this one could live up to that same hype, guys.
Oh, first man. One missed, second one didn't.
Effective. Oh, and a stomp.
Oh!
Both wrists captured.
That was nasty.
Take a good look at a real-life Titan, folks. Foot to the midsection.
Buries a knee to the body.
Ooh, treading all over their opponent. Here's a combo of strikes. Wow.
Party's over. Hit the lights.
Morrison saw it coming.
Able to give him the slip.
Oh, right to the side of the face.
Hoist it up. Down and out.
And he has to start protecting himself from attacks to that area.
Oh, man.
Oh, what impact.
Morrison was ready for that.
Oh, vicious running knee lift.
Oh my gosh, what impact.
Oh, with authority. Oh, and a stomp. Stop gloating and put your attention back to the match.
Hoist it up.
Feast your up.
I love that so many WWE superstars care so much about the world and their community.
You know what one of my favorite sounds in the world is? Hearing the crack of a kendo stick over someone's back. I heard it at the first event I went to, and it stuck with me ever since. I would love to see how vicious you could be with a kendo stick in your hand.
Throughout history, there have been laws and rules to keep society moving tight. No such thing. And that's the way we like it, Cole. No rules, just raw power and straight up anarchy.
It takes a certain kind of superstar to thrive in the chaotic atmosphere of extreme rules.
Hey, you're right, Byron. It helps if you have a screw loose.
You said it, not me.
Speaking of having a couple of screws loose, I think I'm going a little nuts myself working alongside you two. Boom! He's taking this to the floor now.
He's got a kendo stick, a weapon we've seen used to great effect time and time again.
And these attacks are spelling nothing but trouble. And you never want to count a competitor. Seems to be no signs of defense right now. Cruz's resolve might be wavering here.
Some flaws in Cruz's game plan are being exposed.
He has a task at hand, but prefers to be showboating right now. Cruz with retaliation.
Apollo is going to look to press on the advantage.
Could be a change of fortunes for Cruz. Great counter, impressive ring IQ on display there.
Each superstar trying to stay a step ahead.
Buffet of strikes.
Apollo Crews is busted open, guys.
A little thunder roll.
Stomping down. He's running.
He's trying again.
Standing shooting star. Price and Crowd.
Feeling like it's over for Apollo.
And that's all she wrote.
Mr. Amazing, the Falcon Black.
You cannot say they didn't give it their all and then some to achieve this victory.
Never a doubt, barely a moment's suspense. This one was about as lopsided as they come.
Heard you're bad-mouthing me in the locker room, saying the camera angles I shoot you from are making you look weak. Really? It's not easy being a WWE cameraman. But I'm glad not all WWE superstars are so cruel to the crew. In fact, I've got a friend who has my back and thinks my work is pretty great.
And you can sense the anger emanating from the competitor tonight. Eyes like a blazing fire. This is a man you don't want to be in front of right now. He's a man possessed is what he is. As for Kofi Kingston, I've said it before, as talented as he is, as much veteran experience as he has, none of that matters if he can't focus. I don't know about you, but I actually think Bootios and pancakes serve as a distraction.
Oh, that's because you don't understand the power of positivity, Corey. Wouldn't you call a distraction? That's all just fuel for Kofi.
Just punishing their opponent. Exclamation point. Look at him. Pride and poise personified. Kofi Kingston needs to rally. Kofi has to rely on his veteran instincts to come back. Kofi got him back.
Kofi doing what he can do to halter the beatdown.
The U-turn Kofi needed in this match could have been that right there. Oh, big boot.
Stomping the leg.
He's in a little bit of trouble now.
And hanging tough, but beginning to show some wear and tear. Might want to think about picking up the pace a bit.
The fight is being brought right to him. He can't allow himself to let up now.
Rolling thunder into the flatliner.
Really just laying it in.
Setting up again.
Ridiculous standing shooting star. This was as dominant a win as I've ever seen, guys. That's why they call it light work, Cole. Barely even broke a sweat.
My podcast listeners absolutely love to cheer on a villain. After all, morality and playing fair can be a bit stale. So they'd lose their minds to see you crush someone's dreams and body in a no DQ match.
This is a no disqualification match. Anything someone can dream up to do to their opponent is legal. Take the rules and throw them out the window.
Well, this allows the superstar to pursue victory by any means necessary. And some experience a state of twisted ecstasy while punishing their adversary.
We are witnessing an environment where competitors can embrace their anger and aggressive instincts because it's all legal.
I'm glad you're done believing in fairy tales, Saxton. The hero doesn't always win. Sometimes you have to embrace the darkness.
His arm, vicious.
Come on.
Absorbed some damage already.
It's nothing he hasn't been through before. He's reminding his competition that they'll only ever be second best.
Dominic with a reversal. Reciprocating the initial reversal.
Oh.
Both wrists captured.
And Dominic's resolve might be wavering here.
Dominic needs to
perched up top. Diving knee drop. Stand much more of this.
Dominic now is going to have to dig down deep.
Vicious kicks to the jaw. The end is looming now. And he has just taken an extraordinary amount of abuse.
Oof. Turnaround there keeps Dominic away from more danger.
Dominic was getting beaten down, but he could have just changed the pace with that move.
Turning the tables. He's returning fire.
All the way up and down. I think we know what's coming next.
In the wheel. Inside the ring.
He's stalking his opponent from the top turnbuckle.
Knees to the chest.
Surprisingly fast victory here tonight.
There's the consequences of getting caught unprepared. Just goes to show you, you gotta be on your toes at all times.
I love that so many WWE super...
I know you and I have mostly been doing our own thing on SmackDown, but I think it's time for that to change.
Why is that?
Because we have a special bond from training together at the PC. Even though we weren't always on the same page, that bond is still there. It means something.
Just tell me what you want.
What I want is the Intercontinental Championship. And I want you to help me get it. I already have my old buddy Nakamura here, and there's power in numbers. If you'll join us.
Okay, I'm willing to give this a shot. What's your plan?
I've already had a couple matches, but he's always found a way to escape with his championship. So with our help, you're going to beat him, then give me a title match. Deal?
So how about tonight I get his attention? He has a match scheduled, but I'll make sure he never makes it to the ring.
I like it. See? I have a feeling this is gonna work out just fine.
What's happening here? He's ambushing Big E. That's what's happening.
He's not even scheduled to face Big E tonight. Somebody needs to get out here and put an end to this. Talk about a bombshell. Big E's mystery partner's been revealed to be none other than WWE legend Shawn Michaels.
Big E pulls the big surprise as his tag team partner here tonight, and he certainly delivered.
Wow! Paragon Jay Pierce and his cronies were expecting an advantage tonight, but they can kiss that goodbye now.
Great reversal.
Oh, stomping away. Sequence of reversals there.
Can they go on the attack?
Both wrists captured.
That was nasty.
Wasting absolutely no respect on his opponent. You gotta love it.
Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want. Launch face first.
Evading offense. Running knee lift. He's looking a little off balance.
Oh, and a stomp. Oh, look at these kicks. Oh.
Rights and lefts, elbows, knees, all of them lethal.
For a back kick. Just like that, Big E finds a counter.
Shawn Michaels tags in.
Tagging his partner in now. He saw it coming, taking advantage.
Back and forth from these competitors.
Right to the ribs.
A little rope assistance, punishing their opponent.
A little thunder roll.
Big E looks like a sitting duck right now.
Snapmare.
Digging into walls that didn't even know existed.
Stomping the leg.
Oh, man.
Great. Turn your lights out.
Brutal stomp to the body. And just getting started. Look at this brutality.
This is how you torture your opponent.
Oh, my God. This is hard to watch.
saw that one coming, took advantage. Shifts it back onto him.
Oh boy,
German suplex released. Bicycle knee strike. This match may be nearing its limit.
At this point, it might be too much for him to recover from, Cole.
This is where Big E really needs to hear that New Day rock shit.
Snapmare takeover.
Basement kick to the side of the
shoulders down.
Real European uppercut.
That's gotta feel good. Sweet, sweet victory.
Here are your winners, Mr. Amazing, the Falcon, Black Paragon, Jay Pierce, and Shinsuke Nakamura.
That is the kind of win that opens eyes here in WWE.
A major victory here.
You could just sense the intensity in the air throughout this one.